first reading this morning is from 2 Samuel, chapter 17, verses 1 through 11 and 16. Now when the king was settled in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all his enemies around him, the king said to the prophet Nathan, "See now, I am living in a house of cedar, but the ark of God stays in a tent." Nathan said to the king, "Go, do all that you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that same night, the word of the Lord came to Nathan, "Go and tell my servant David, 'Thus says the Lord, are you the one to build me a house to live in? I have not lived in a house since the day I brought up the people from Israel to Israel from Egypt to this day, but I have been moving about the tent in the tabernacle. Whenever I have moved among the people, all the people of Israel, did I ever speak a word with any of the tribal leaders of Israel whom I commanded to shepherd my people Israel, saying, why have you not built me a house of cedar? Now therefore, thus you shall say to my servant David, thus says the Lord of hosts, I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep, to be prince over my people of Israel, and I have been with you wherever you went, and have cut off all your enemies from before you, and I will make you a great name, like the name of the great ones of the earth. And I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them, so that they may live in one place and be disturbed no more. And evildoers shall afflict them no more as formerly, from the time that I appointed judges over my people of Israel. And I will give you rest from all your enemies. Moreover, the Lord declares to you that the Lord will make you a house. Your house and your kingdom shall be made sure forever before me. Your throne shall be established forever." The word of the Lord.
I will read the white print and we will read the dark print. My soul proclaimed the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoiced in God, my Savior.
For you, Lord, have looked in favor on your holy servant. From this day all generations will call you blessed.
You, the Almighty, have done great things for me, and holy is your name.
Never shall those who fear you from generation to generation.
You have shown strength with your arm and scattered the proud in their conceit.
Cast down the mighty from their thrones and lifted up the lowly.
You have filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty.
You have promised to aid your servant Israel and the promise of mercy.
The promise made to our forebears, to Abraham and his children forever.
The second reading this morning is from the book of Romans, chapter 15, verses 25 through 27. Now to God, who is able to strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery that was kept secret for long ages but is now disclosed, and through the prophetic writings is made known to all Gentiles, according to the command of the eternal God to bring about the obedience of faith, to the only God, only wise God, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever. Amen. Glory to the Lord.
Thank you, God.